This is a 2-mark question asked in GATE 2020 of electrical. This is from signal system subjects and from the Laplace transform concepts. The question is, the causal realization of a system transform function H of S having poles locations are given and zero locations are given. So based on this, we want to comment regarding the stability, whether it is real complex and whether it is low pass, high pass or all pass. Okay, based on the options, you can say like this. So basically, the pole locations are given. Let's say this is P1, this is P2, this is Z1, Z2, these are the zeros. So if you want to plot their pole zero plot, where they'll be lying. Actually, this kind of notation means this is the real part of the pole, this is the imaginary part of the poles, like that. So if I ask you to plot it, where it will be, let's say 2 is, this is the S plane, this is 2, this is 2 and the real part is 2, and imaginary part is minus 1. So real axis you come to, imaginary axis, this is minus 1. So this is 2 comma minus 1, okay? So this is P1. And where about P2? Where P2 lie? P2 is coming minus 2, 1. So if this is 2, so this will be minus 2 and plus 1. So this much of height, so this is be your P2. What about Z1, Z2? Z1 is 2 comma 1. So 2 this side and this side is 1. So it will be like this. And what about minus 2, minus 1? Minus 2, minus 1 will be something like this. So this is the pole zero plot of the given system. Okay. Now coming to stability. So this is given that the system is causal. So this is already given in the questions. So if the system is causal, when the stability will happen? So you know very well, if the system is causal in nature, to achieve stability, all the poles of the system should lie on the left half of S plane. If any one of the pole lie on the right half of S plane, then the system is said to be unstable. So in this case, because this pole is lying on the right half of S plane, then obviously this is an unstable system. So because one of the pole is lying on the right half of S plane, this is an unstable system. And whether real or complex, so we want to comment regarding whether the impulse response will be real or complex. Do remember, so in the real system, the pole zero, they occurs in the complex conjugate pair. If they are the complex roots, they occurs in the conjugate pair. It will never happen. Let's say for example, what I mean to say is, if I have a poles, if the pole location is, let's say it is 1 plus j, then it means if this is a pole, then definitely I'll have one more pole which is P1 conjugate or which is 1 minus J. In other words, if a pole is happening here, then compulsorily a pole will happen here. This is the property of a real system. If this is not happening, this is not a real system, this will be a complex systems. So not only for poles, for zero also. So if a zero is here, then there must be a zero here. So this will always occur in the conjugate pair. So if a complex root is there, if it is a pole or zero, then its corresponding conjugate must also be a pole or zero. So if it is happening, it is a real system. If it is not happening, it is not a real system. But here, you can see, like if this is the pole, we expect there should be pole here. Or if this is a zero, we expect there should be a zero here. But this is not happening, right? So this is not satisfying this property. So since poles and zeros, which are complex in nature, they are not in the conjugate pair, then I can say this is not a real system. This is a complex system. This is a complex systems. What is the reason? Complex poles and zeros are not in conjugate pair. So this is the property of the real system. If it is a real system, they should be in conjugate pair. If they are not in conjugate pair, it is not a real system. It is complex systems. So we have commented regarding the stability. It is unstable and this is not a real system. This is complex systems. Then the third thing is, what about the, the filter nature, whether it is low pass, high pass, all pass, what it is. From this symmetric arrangements, it is very much clear that this will definitely represent an all pass filter, right? Why? You should get that feel like, because they are symmetrically located with respect to G omega axis. I mean, the height of each one of this and the width, how far they are. They are symmetric, then it will be definitely all pass filter. If you are not getting what I'm saying, then you can do something like this. If you ask me to write the the transfer function of this. So if I ask you what is the zeros, so this zero is what? This is the zero location. If I ask you, this Z1 is nothing but 2 plus J1, this is minus 2 minus J1, this is Z2. And what is P1? P1 is 2 minus J, P2 is minus 2 plus J. So, here the transfer function, we can write it like this: S minus Z1 into S minus Z2, S minus P1 into S minus P2. So, if I substitute this Z1, Z2, etc., what do I get? I get S minus Z1, S minus 2 minus J1, isn't it? So, that if I find the root of it, I will get this 2 plus J1. This S minus Z2. So, if I do this, so this will be S plus 2 plus J1, S minus P1. So, this is S minus 2 plus J, and this is S minus P2. This is S plus 2 minus J. Right? So, now if I expand it, what do you get? So, all this S, you can replace it by J omega. So, it will be J omega minus J1 minus 2. This is J omega plus J1 plus 2. This is J omega minus 2 plus J, and this is J omega minus J plus 2. Right? So, this can be further written as minus 2 plus J into omega minus 1, and this is 2 plus J into omega plus 1 divided by, this is minus 2 plus J into omega plus 1, and this is 2 plus J, and this is omega minus 1. So, this is what? This H of J omega. So, this is what I have written is, what is this? This is H of J omega. This is H of J omega. But if I ask you to tell me what is J omega magnitudes, from there you can comment what kind of filter is it. So, if you try to find the magnitude of this, what do you get? You will get, it is like x plus iy form. So, x square is 4 plus omega minus 1 square is the magnitude of this term. And for this, this is your 4 plus omega plus 1 whole square. Similarly, this is square root of 4 plus omega plus 1 whole square. Similarly, this is 4 plus omega minus 1 whole square. If you see this, this factor and this factor will be cancelled. This factor and this factor will be cancelled. So, what you are getting is, this H of J omega mod is 1 for all frequencies. H of J omega equal to 1 for all frequency. So, that is definitely the property of the all pass filter. That is, the magnitude is independent of frequency. This is constant for all frequency. So, this will pass all the frequency components. Depending on the frequency, there will be change in the phase, but magnitude will be always constant for all frequency. And that's definitely the property of the all pass filter. So, the answer is unstable, complex, and this is all pass. You see, one of the option is given like this: unstable, complex system, and all pass. And that is the right answer for this question.